Time for the championship game of the Putnam County Tournament. South Putnam scoring just their third win of the season last night and knocking off North Putt. Now looking at a surprise, maybe an even larger upset, taking on the Cloverdale Clovers coming in at 14-6. We welcome you to the McAnally Center here in Greencastle, home of the Tiger Cubs, home of our championship game, and this broadcast on Endeavor Communications alongside Sean Walker and the legendary coach Pat Rady, Greg Rakestraw with you. Thank you so much for joining us for tonight's game. And Pat, I will start with you. This has got to feel a bit strange to be broadcasting the game of a team that you were coaching until about 3 or 4 months ago.
Yes, it's going to be tough. And then with our son being the coach, it's going to be added a little more tougher. But I'll try to remain neutral.
You don't have to. I think everybody understands as far as that is concerned. Your son, Patrick, now taking over an outstanding team. You racked up a lot of wins the last 2 years at Cloverdale. This team is 14-6. Cooper Neese, Jalen Moore, quite the dynamic duo, and they were an evening ago.
Yes, they were. They were both, Jalen's our sixth man, but Cooper is the only starter coming back, and so they've really done quite well. Patrick has done a good job of bringing them along, and they've had some tough times at playing some, Edgewood and Linton. That's four of their losses right there, those two teams right there, but they're having good years, and so they're playing pretty good basketball right now.
Cooper, a junior, headed for Butler University. Jalen, just a sophomore, but in this team's top eight, two sophomores, two freshmen, two junior. Very kind of spread out in terms of the classifications of the players for the Clovers. For South Putnam, we mentioned this in the last broadcast. We'll bring it up again here. They are playing North Putt for the third time in 15 days last night. Lost the first two, got them in a very controlled half-court game. Now, Sean, can they do it again tonight against this talented offensive bunch from Cloverdale?
I will never say never again after what I just saw in the first game that we just watched. I mean, there is a reason you play the game. And right now, South Putnam probably watched that game and said, you know what? Look what they just did. We can do the same thing, and they're probably going to come in with some confidence.
We talk about the roster being pretty diverse in terms of freshmen, sophomores, juniors, seniors for Cloverdale. For South Putnam, it's exact opposite. I'm not sure I've ever seen anything like it. Their roster is either seniors or freshmen. They're a group that has struggled the last 3 years. They have won just 10 combined games over the last three seasons, but clearly the future is awfully bright for this team. Tell us, Pat, about this South Putnam group.
Well, they're a group that's really come on, and there again, they lost some earlier. They're playing a lot better now. They've got some players that played football, and they're getting their basketball legs under them, and they had some injuries, and they got those guys back. So they're not the same team. It's a little bit like North Putnam. They're not the same team as they were first of the year. And they're playing, they've lost some really close games in the last few games they played. And they're coming in with a lot of confidence.
Let's talk about impact players for tonight's game. Let's start with the visitors from South Putnam. They've got just one double-digit score. It is Allen Plunkett, a freshman, 12 points per basketball game. Tell us what you saw from Allen tonight ago.
Well, he was awesome. You know, they're going to roll some of the highlights here of him from last night. But, man, he was dead on from the top of the key. And for whatever reason, it just dialed in. And if he comes out and does this tonight, Cloverdale could be in a little bit of trouble. And you saw him, he was hitting the threes, but then he started showing you some of his crafty game where he would get into the lane and pump fake and move. And just, it was amazing for a freshman to have that good of footwork, in my opinion, and had a good inside-outside game as well. But none bigger than the last shot that he hit. There was about 4 seconds on the clock when he let it go, and that was the deciding bucket. Gave him the win by two.
Again, just their third win of the season, just their second win against an IHSAA-affiliated school, and first one of those since knocking off Turkey Run in the opening game of the year back on December the 1st. Now, his opposite number tonight is Cooper Neese, the talented junior that is bound for Butler. 29 points per game, 8.5 rebounds per game, 3.5 steals per game. Tell us about the talents that make this kid a Division I player a couple of years from now.
Well, he's been a gym rat, and he puts a lot of time into the basketball. He doesn't take any off times, and he plays puts a lot of time in the summer. He puts AAU ball, and he is well worth it. He's come from a very good basketball family. The last three sectionals that Cloverdale's won, Jerry, their father, was on the one in the 80s, the last sectional there. And then in 07, when we won the section there, his brother Michael played for me and won that one. And so when he came on the varsity, I told him the pressure was on, that Anise would always get a sectional. And so He helped get one last year, and we hope that that's not the last one.
Your son Patrick on the sidelines getting ready to lead the charge for the Clovers, looking for that Putnam County Championship. With that, let's take this quick timeout. We'll come back with the starting lineups and opening tip-off of our championship game, South Putnam and Cloverdale on Endeavor Communications.
Keep your family connected with Endeavor eWireless. Endeavor offers affordable individual plans with unlimited voice and messaging and family share plans with your choice of data plans up to 20 gigabits. Endeavor eWireless runs on a quality 4G LTE network with nationwide coverage. Choose from popular smartphones. You can even bring in your own phone. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit weendeavor.com for more details about Endeavor eWireless plans.
I don't think of this as a high school weight room. It's more like a high school classroom. I'm learning how to manage my time here. I'm learning that it's important to have goals and that it takes persistence and commitment to reach them. And I'm learning that the best way to lead is by example.
Indiana High School Sports. They're more than just a game.
Come and see me play.
Endeavor Communications continues to be the leader of technology in the communities we serve. We provide crystal clear voice, super fast internet, exciting television entertainment, security systems for home and business, medical alert systems, IT services, and our new 4G LTE wireless telephone service with nationwide coverage. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Great job by the choral group here at Greencastle High School on our national anthem while we were away. Time now for the starting lineups for tonight's game. South Putnam will be the visitors on the scoreboard for a second straight night. Let's talk about their starting five. Again, Alan Plunkett is their leading scorer at 12 points per contest. And what's unique about this group, Sean, is the fact their two leading scorers on the season are both freshmen.
It is. And what an asset that is to have. You got youth, which means the future is bright for these guys, and if you can get them to play well now, look out.
So Plunkett and Scott, their next several scorers are all seniors. But other than Plunkett, he's the only not only double-digit scorer, but he's one of just two guys that averages more than 5 points a basketball game. And they can take a look, Plunkett and Scott in the starting lineup for South Putnam.
You know, another player that played really well last night for them was Jimmy Rutter. He did a nice job with those mid-range jumpers. I think he finished the game with 8 points and just found a way to crash glass and do a good job all around for him as well.
Thomas Fanning is a freshman point guard as well, so three freshmen in the starting five for head coach Greg D. Now for the Clovers of Cloverdale High School. We've talked a lot about Cooper Neese, and rightfully so. Coach, tell us about the young man we see on our screen right now in Jalen Moore.
Jalen Moore is a deceptive. He's very quick. He can handle the ball well. He likes to penetrate, but he can't hit the three. And he was really he shot some really pressure three free throws last night. That was a big factor.
They've got a freshman starter as well in Jake Wilkes. So you'll see a youth movement on both of these teams.
Yes, Wilkes has come in and added some spark. He got some. I think he's averaging maybe around 6 points a game, and he on the boards and. He's very deceptive because this is only his second year of playing basketball.
Pretty awesome to be that good already.
Yeah.
I mean, he's made a huge contribution. You know, I said this last night, Greg and Coach. I said that Jalen Moore reminded me of a young Yogi Ferrell. I mean, his game, he finds a way even amongst the trees. They still get the ball up on the glass, and he can shoot it well. Great handles.
He's very deceptive. Okay.
Neese will jump at center for Cloverdale and win the tip. Moore will track it down. Moore and Neese, 47 of the 67 points per game for the Clovers. Nice on cue. Three in the corner.
Well, that's a great start right there for Cooper right away. I mean, you see how quick the release is. It no sooner touched his hands than it was in the bottom of the net.
2-2-1, full court pressure applied by the Clovers. South Putnam across the time stripe in time, and now we'll see exactly how deliberate the Eagles want to be. Defensively, Pat, what should we expect to see from Cloverdale?
I think a zone early, and we'll see what happens. If they could, yeah, I think you may see them try to trap a little bit, but I think they've kind of gone to a zone, and that's, oops.
Shot taken and missed by Dalton Scott. The drive by Moore. Ball knocked out of his hands. It'll remain Cloverdale basketball.
Double checking there, Jalen, making sure he's not bleeding. Took a shot to the mouth.
These two teams, county rivals, conference rivals, same sectional as well. Moore on the dive, and Jake Wilkes the basket.
But I tell you, if we're only playing for 2 years, I mean, that's a pretty good mind to know, cut right there and get a wide open layup.
So another 5-0 start, nearly a turnover. Eventually, it will be a turnover. South Putnam on the giveaway. In our first game, North Putt got off to a great start. South Putt, not so much yet. Nice the miss from three. And I believe it's going to be last touch by South Putnam out of bounds to the Clovers.
That's great effort by Nick Winders. I mean, he creates a second opportunity here for Cloverdale.
Cloverdale, the only team with a winning record in their sectional, which is located at Southmont this year. Four teams from what is now the Western Indiana Conference, but the old WCC members in there, along with former conference rival Monrovia, now part of the Indiana Crossroads Conference, and Southmont, which is the smallest school in the Sagamore Conference. Reach-in foul going to be called against the freshman in Plunkett.
Yeah, that's a learning way to coach him up there when Plunkett comes out, and they'll talk to him about that one, because path is not going around you. There's no reason to reach on that play.
Knee splits two defenders all the way in. He got hacked. He'll shoot two. Cooper, an 86% free throw shooter.
You'll see the replay here. McHugh tries to get there, just not quick enough. He's about a step too slow on that help side defense.
And South Putnam's best player in Plunkett has picked up two quick fouls in the opening 2 minutes. And Nice, an 86% free throw shooter to the line. And now Plunkett will have to sit. Sprindlock will come in for South Putnam. ...7-0 run to start the game for Cloverdale. A little different variation of the pressure here. More of a 1-2-2 from Cloverdale. Everything around the perimeter of that pressure. And just past the 10-second line in time are the Eagles.
I think for the young team for South Putnam, if they can just get the ball across and not turn it over a ton in this game, that'll be a huge learning experience for these young players.
Four out, one in. Quick jump shot for South Putnam does not go. That's Brinlock. And the rebound controlled by the Clovers. And Moore goes right by Fanning. Off the window, misses. Able to pick back up the rebound. And then Dalton Scott just kind of walked him out of bounds. So it'll be a foul against South Putnam.
Jalen's so quick. You see here, establishes himself back in bounds for the rebound.
Moore in the baseline corner. The lefty's three is good. So both Nice and Moore, each with a triple. And it's a 10-0 start for Cloverdale. And another turnover by South Putt. And Nice will dial his own number and connect. And a timeout coming by South Putnam. It's the start the Eagles likely feared. It is a full timeout. And we will step aside as well. 12-0, Clovers in front in this county championship game on Endeavor Communications.
Your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish most.
Look inside the huddle of Greg Dean. Trying to devise a way for this team to get a little better look at the basket, but doing so without their best player, who's got two fouls, and Allen Plunkett. 12-0 start for Cloverdale to this game.
Yeah, it's been a great run from Cloverdale. They really jumped out on them early. You know, to preach chaos, so that philosophy did not end when Pat Rady Sr. retired. Pat Rady Jr. is running the same thing. So
1-2-2. Fanning into the front court. The trap continues in the half court. Nice knocks it away. It'll remain South Putnam basketball.
Well, Coach, I think I told you this last year when watching Cloverdale play at times on defense. It was almost like there was 10 of you out there on the floor. You know, it's like a swarm of bees.
And here comes the zone. Extended pressure. South Putnam turns over yet again. Nice the look ahead for Moore. And Moore finishes. Jalen Moore with five. And a reach-in foul going to be called here against the Clovers. All right, explain the chaos theory, if you will. Now, without giving away your son's secrets, explain it to us. When you're talking about chaos on defense, what did you want to see?
Well, we just want to rack havoc, and we didn't want to take the word from Chaka Smart, so we had to come up with a different word, so we just came up with chaos. But it's basically pressing and just causing chaos and a lot of confusion, and we'll mix up the defenses. Sometimes you notice it's been a 2-2.
Tipped away by Nice, stays in play.
Yep.
Sounds like a friend of mine that was at a low Division One. He wanted to emulate the Arkansas style, and Nolan Richardson was famous for the phrase 40 minutes of hell.
Yep.
And he caused his 40 minutes of disturbing the peace, is how he referred to his. I've heard that before.
DTP.
Moore, no. Rebound, weak side, put back, yes, for Wilkes.
Well, you cannot allow that if you're South Putnam. I mean, you can't. You get what you want, which is a deep three, and then you give up the offensive rebound.
Oh, backward line.
16-0 in favor of the Clovers. The dream start for Cloverdale. At the elbow, jump shot does not go, and no one close to the offensive glass for South Putnam. Dalton Scott the miss. At the other end, wide open three does not go for Winders, and South Putnam will track down the loose ball. And here comes the half-court trap. Scramble for it. And eventually, they're going to say a timeout will be given to South Putnam. 30-second timeout taken. We'll keep it right here. But already the Eagles have burned two of their five timeouts in the opening 4.5 minutes of the game. And if you're Coach Dean, when you've yet to score and you're down 16 halfway through the first quarter, what are you trying to do with your kids in the huddle?
Well, I have to refer to a time, and I don't know you, Greg, but you remember when I coached Shelbyville and we played Muncie Central, and they was going for the third championship in the semi-state, and we was down something like 19-2, and I've never been one to like to call the first timeout. And so I finally called the timeout, and I told the kids not to panic. And we came back and upset them because we won the low-scoring game, and we wanted to slow the ball down and play a half-court game and still wanted to stay with our game plan. We didn't want to get in a running game, and so even though he was down 19-2, we came back and won 44-42 or something like that.
Correct me if I'm wrong, that led to a great article written that was titled The Greatest Upset of 74, was it not?
No, I think that was when Winchester and we upset Hammond.
Okay.
They ranked number one.
Gotcha.
Up at the Huntington Tournament.
You got so many accolades, they all just run together in my mind. I don't know how you keep them all straight.
So the turnover by South Putnam, their fourth. Now Paff the drive. And Wilkes on the baseline, no. Good board is there for Winders. His first points, fourth different Clover to score. And the route continues here in the opening quarter. Tipped out of bounds by Cloverdale. And not much choice here for South Putnam. Plunkett has to return with two fouls.
You have to.
It's a South Putnam team that is averaging 42 points a game.
I mean, look how far Cloverdale is extending that defense.
You kind of want to call it a 2-3, 1-2-2 zone, but Nice is just kind of allowed to play free safety and kind of roam wherever he wants to. hard to attack a zone. You don't exactly know what it is.
That's true, too.
Plunkett from 30. Barely draws iron. That ball was touched last off a path. It'll remain South Putnam ball.
You know, but in the 30 seconds that they passed that ball around, that was the most open opportunity they had from that far out. I mean,
Plunkett will check back out. Don't think the Coach Dean appreciated the shot selection that time. Now Brennan Hall will check in, 6'5 senior. And also checking in for Cloverdale will be Parker Watts.
Another freshman.
6 foot freshman. A bit of a 2-3 zone, but players allowed to freelance a little bit to cause the havoc, cause that chaos. And everything really about 25 feet from the basket for South Putnam, if not further out. One of the things that you're seeing South Putnam not do, they'll fire a three here and get it. Mm-hmm. So finally on the board, it's a triple from Fanning. We'll kind of dissect how to attack his own next possession down. Winder's the runner. Mm-hmm. That's up and good. He's got four.
That was a good-looking drive that time from Winder's.
2-2-1. Into the front court comes South Putnam. They'll let another three go, and this one misses badly, but no weak side presence there to rebound out of that zone, and the putback is good. That is Lane Watson with the basket.
Yeah, I think he was surprised he was that wide open when the shot went long.
Second field goal of the quarter, and a blocking foul coming here. And this will be called against Watson. So Watson, one of the five freshmen on the varsity roster for South Putnam. Watson playing in just his eighth game this season. And by the way, that putback basket, his first points of the year at the varsity level. Bounds intended for Nice, but Winder's able to track it down. Deep three, Nice does not go. And an easy board for South Putnam. The one thing that you're seeing South Putnam not do against this zone, you still have to run some variation of a man-to-man offense against a lot of good zones. Elbow jump shot will not get the roll. Some coaches like on-ball screens, some coaches don't, but they're awfully effective when you're trying to attack a zone defense.
Yes, you can. I think you've.
Wow. Ooh. Beautiful drive by Moore.
That was pretty.
Moving, yeah.
That makes a very famous friend of his smile in the front row. We'll tell you more about him as the broadcast goes along. 22-5, Cloverdale. Drive by South Putt is good.
That was a good take by Trevor Long that time, using his strength, just getting all the way to the bucket.
Long, the senior, with the basket. South Putnam trying to figure things out offensively, but still have their work cut out for them. Moore dials his own number. No. Long rebound, put back, not in time. Cloverdale, a 15-point lead here in the Putnam County Championship game. They lead South Putnam 22-7. Back after this on Endeavor Communications.
Want to know what I like best about playing basketball for my high school? I like it because it's a place where my friends get to see me play. I like it because I'm playing for someone besides myself. I'm playing for everybody in my school and every person in my community.
Indiana High School Sports. They're more than just a game.
Come and see me play.
Endeavor Communications continues to be the leader of technology in our communities. We provide crystal clear voice, super fast internet, exciting television entertainment, security for home and business, medical alert systems, IT services for home or business, and our new 4G LTE wireless telephone service with nationwide coverage. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Tonight's game brought to us by eShield Security Solutions. Give them a call, the number you see on your screen. And if you're like, That guy looks like Trey Lyles. Because that is Trey Lyles of the Utah Jazz. Yeah. He is a family friend of Jalen Moore's. Yeah. And so that's the reason why he is here at the game on his All-Star break. And it's amazing to see the Hoosier kids come home. Brad Stevens was at the Butler game today. And Trey is back here in Indianapolis.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, and Cody Zeller at the IU game the other night as well after they beat the Pacers. And Charlotte beat the Pacers.
Traveling violation called against Fanning. Fifth South Putnam turnover. So Trey's like any other fan. He's literally taking cell phone video of the game as we speak. I love seeing that. Pressure now applied by South Putt. Nice handles it well and finds Wilkes for the easy basket.
Well, you know, when you're famous, you got to keep that Twitter account up to date all the time. You know, you got to constantly let your fans know where you're at.
Trey, of course, won a state championship, was the Medal Attitude Award winner at Tech High School. Drive, good look, just didn't fall for Plunk, but that's the right idea against this zone. 24-7. Nice, pretty move.
Yep. I tell you, you know, for Plunkett, he's got to stay poised here. It's tough when you get into a game and you pick up a couple of fouls. You get out of that rhythm early, and you got to try to find your way back into a game where everybody else has already established their rhythm.
Fanning almost turns it over. A lot of youth on the floor right now for South Putt. They've got four freshmen on the floor as we speak.
It may not pay off right now today or this year, but it's going to benefit them in the future.
Fight for the loose ball. South Putt able to track it down. Good look. Mm-hmm. And Scott gets the basket.
That was it. That was a beautiful pass. Nice finish.
26-9. Stewart, number five for South Putnam, the only senior on the floor. Moore right by his man and lays it up and in.
Yeah, he's too quick. You can't give up the baseline like that to him. You got to force him back to the middle where the help's at.
And the pressure kind of more of just the slow him down variety right now. And then into the half court, Cloverdale gets into the traps. Low block, soft spot of that zone. Open three for Plunkett, does not go. Fanning, good pressure on the weak side, but it'll remain Cloverdale basketball. Hall will check back in. Winders will check back in. Paff and Watts will have a breather for Cloverdale. Now a little zone action from South Putnam. They'll do a little 1-2-2 of their own. Right idea, trying to find the man in the middle, but a turnover. And then a foul going to be given by Jalen Moore, his second, and Plunkett will shoot two.
That's a good foul by Moore. You don't want to give up an easy layup here. Make him earn him from the free throw line. Nothing, no ill intent there. Going for the ball.
Cloverdale coming in on a five-game winning streak, including going to overtime with Greencastle last night. A two-point game and a four-point game, the way last night's games were decided. A four-point win for North Putnam over Greencastle earlier tonight. But this game, not one of those varieties as we speak, and two missed free throws for the freshman in Plunkett. Nice past two defenders and turns it over trying to find a teammate. Back-to-back giveaways for the Clovers, their first two of the game. And South Putnam spacing four shooters around the arc against this zone and get that one to go. That was a two, a long two, but a basket nonetheless for Dalton Scott. Three for Cloverdale, misses everything, and Scott will let it trickle out of bounds.
I'd say I almost get the feeling that Cloverdale's relaxed a little bit now. They've taken their foot off the gas pedal, and you don't want to do that. Not early in a basketball game.
If you're not careful, they'll ease back in.
You can create some offense with your defense, though, and Nice just weaves his way through like it was geometry class, taking angles to the basket.
Played it smart.
11 for Nice. Cloverdale team has two more games remaining. They'll play again on Tuesday against Rockville, then finishing up against Eminence maybe 6 days from now. Three in the corner. Does not go. And the rebound tracked down by Wilkes for Cloverdale. Half for three. Got that one.
Very capable shooter out there.
Yes,
we saw him earlier in the season against Owen Valley. He had 20 points in that game, hit four threes.
First player other than Nice or Moore to make a triple. And the lead grows to 22 for the Clovers. Plunkett from 18. Got that one.
There you go.
Well, you can see the talent this kid has, just a freshman. He will be a very good high school basketball player. Nice kind of got bailed out because he was trying to throw that to a teammate and it bounced off the leg of a South Putnam player.
Yeah.
I believe a foul going to be called against Cloverdale going for the loose ball.
Well, imagine if Plunkett grows a little bit more too. I mean, you give him two or three more inches. He's 6'7" with the ball handling ability he's got and the range he's got. Look out.
Well, we'll see how smart Jalen plays. He's got two fouls. He's coming back in. Same as Plunkett from South Putnam. He's got two, 3:34 to go.
2-2-1 full court pressure. Broken rather easily by South Putnam. And then Wilkes, kind of an unnecessary bump.
Yeah.
Extends the arm. His first foul, team four.
That looked more like a hockey body block or something, like he tried to put him into the boards.
Yeah, that's lack of experience. He's just got to turn and sprint and get in front of the offensive player instead of running alongside of him.
The South Putnam program, they've had one winning season since 2003. They're going to have a lot of four-year varsity kids a few years down the road. You can call that a block or a steal. Either way, Cloverdale in transition. And Moore going to commit the offensive fouls. There's that third foul. And Moore will check right back out as Paff will replace him.
Boy, I don't know. This is a tough one for me. It looks like McHugh's still kind of sliding. Might have got his feet set.
Yeah.
Regardless, that's a huge loss for Cloverdale in this game right now, that with Moore on the bench.
Yeah, it's okay.
Not that they don't have other capable scorers, but now you can focus on Nice.
Yep.
So a 20-point lead for the Clovers. Plunkett, no. Good rebound by Scott. Blocked
Good
by
block.
Wilkes. South Putt can reset. Plunkett fouled. Paff got it.
He does a good job here just getting right into the defense.
Yeah, you can't bail him out. Yeah, that's sometimes you.
Plunkett 0 for 2 from the line tonight. Those are the only two free throws so far for South Putt. And gets that to go. On the season, he is a 69% free throw shooter. First 16 points this game belong to Cloverdale. They've had it somewhat in cruise control ever since. Nice from long distance, no. This ball tracked down by Winders. And now a timeout going to be called by Patrick Rady. And I think he, too, has recognized the fact that his team's been on cruise control for about the last 9 or 10 minutes.
Yeah, I think that part, you know, with Jalen Allen, Jalen creates a lot of things on the offense, get the ball down quickly, and so they got to make some adjustments. I'm sure they've practiced without him there, and hopefully they understand that. But basketball is a game of chess. Greg's going to make some changes. Coach Rady's going to make some changes. And, depends on who. You just hope your run is longer than the other guy's run.
I like it.
Our broadcast line, a service of Endeavor Communications, 800-922-6677, or visit weendeavor.com for all your telecommunications and technology needs. Zone continues here for South Putt. Nice working against it and gets the friendly roll.
That's a great move there by Cooper, realizing that the defender ran him off the spot, and he just steps in and knocks down the mid-range jumper.
13 now for Cooper. And the lead back to 20.
Good pass.
Every possession taking a while for South Putnam. Yeah. Looks aren't coming easy against this zone. And that's a tough shot right there that does not draw iron.
I was just going to say, I'm glad that they're not settling, and then they did.
Tremendous pass by Nice. Yes. Basically about a 60-foot bounce pass to find an open man, but Winders dribbles it off his foot. And an open lane as well.
Yeah.
Mention the fact this Cloverdale squad, the only team in their section with a winning record. They would be in the same regional as some of the Indianapolis area powers in 2A. Indianapolis Howe comes to mind. Three in the corner for South Putnam is good. That's Plunkett.
After a slow start, he's starting to figure it out. He's got it going now with seven.
Second made three by South Putnam. Well, since about the game's opening 5 minutes, South Putt has played them evenly, but still a 17-point game. Wilkes baseline runner, no. But Nice able to track down the rebound. And from the elbow, spins in and out. Wilkes is there. He's got eight.
Great production off the bench and really helping out Cooper right now with Jalen Moore on the bench.
Oh, no, he's getting
Plunkett again. A little long that time. But quick outlet by Hall. One shot. The signal from the sidelines for the Clovers. And Nice will cross the time stripe with 10 seconds left to go in the half. He'll leave it for Winders at four, at three. Nice at two, at one. Splits the defense, but will not get the shot off in time. But at halftime, Cloverdale in command. Our score at the break. Clovers 37, Eagles 18. It's the Putnam County Classic Championship game, courtesy of Endeavor Communications.
Endeavor eTechs provides outstanding IT and computer-related services for your home or business. Whether you need a simple home PC tune-up or a large-scale network installation for your business or your municipality, Endeavor eTechs is your final destination for all of your IT needs. Maintenance agreements are available and services open to members and non-members alike. Call 1-877-524-9109 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Endeavor eShield gives you peace of mind that your home, family, and business are safe. eShield provides burglar protection, leak detection, carbon monoxide, smoke and heat detection, and asset protection to secure your valuables. And of course, there's 24/7 monitoring. Total Connect Remote Services controls your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish most.
TV Everywhere is a value-added entertainment option which gives Endeavor Television subscribers the ability to watch TV programs on their PC, laptop, tablet, or smartphone. When you subscribe to an Endeavor TV package, you receive select TV programming that is available in that package free of charge. You can view Watch TV Everywhere program just about anywhere. All you need is an internet or Wi-Fi connection. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details about Watch TV.
Keep your family connected with Endeavor eWireless. Endeavor offers affordable individual plans with unlimited voice and messaging and family share plans with your choice of data plans up to 20 gigabits. Endeavor eWireless runs on a quality 4G LTE network with nationwide coverage. Choose from popular smartphones. You can even bring in your own phone. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit weendeavor.com for more details about Endeavor eWireless plans.
I don't think of this as a high school weight room. It's more like a high school classroom. I'm learning how to manage my time here. I'm learning that it's important to have goals and that it takes persistence and commitment to reach them. And I'm learning that the best way to lead is by example.
Indiana High School Sports. They're more than just a game.
Come and see me play.
Endeavor Communications continues to be the leader of technology in the communities we serve. We provide crystal clear voice, super fast internet, exciting television entertainment, security systems for home and business, medical alert systems, IT services, and our new 4G LTE wireless telephone service with nationwide coverage. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Endeavor eShield gives you peace of mind that your home, family, and business are safe. eShield provides burglar protection, leak detection, carbon monoxide, smoke and heat detection, and asset protection to secure your valuables. And of course, there's 24/7 monitoring. Total Connect Remote Services controls your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish most.
Want to know what I like best about playing basketball for my high school? I like it because it's a place where my friends get to see me play. I like it because I'm playing for someone besides myself. I'm playing for everybody in my school and every person in my community.
Indiana High School Sports. They're more than just a game.
Come and see me play.
Endeavor Communications continues to be the leader of technology in our communities. We provide crystal clear voice, super fast internet, exciting television entertainment, security for home and business, medical alert systems, IT services for home or business, and our new 4G LTE wireless telephone service with nationwide coverage. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Endeavor eTechs provides outstanding IT and computer-related services for your home or business. Whether you need a simple home PC tune-up or a large-scale network installation for your business or your municipality, Endeavor eTechs is your final destination for all of your IT needs. Maintenance agreements are available and services open to members and non-members alike. Call 1-877-524-9109 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Time now for the Endeavor eTechs Halftime Show. Endeavor eTechs IT Service can help with all your computer and technology needs. 800-922-6677 or weendeavor.com for more details. Cloverdale scored the first 16 points of the game, and they have kept South Putnam at bay ever since. Our score at the break, 37-18. Sean, I'll start with you as the highlights begin to roll. What impressed you about Cloverdale's performance in half number one?
Well, you know, sometimes it's the hot start, and that's exactly what they got. That's why they have the lead right now. And, You know, you can say maybe they took their foot off the gas pedal a little bit, but if it stays and they play even the rest of the way, you still get the win. And so sometimes you get that related a lot of things to boxing. You know, you get that early round in the first part of a fight, and they come out and they throw some haymakers that land. You know, they've stunned that other fighter. Well, now they're up in that fight, and all they got to do is play them, you know, even the rest of the way, and they get the win.
And, Pat, I'll allow you to have the coach's perspective, because usually even up by 19 at halftime, there are things that a coach will see and say, nope, we've got to do better at this. So even with this lead, what can Cloverdale improve on for half number two?
Well, I think they got to make sure where Plunkett is at. I think he's getting some good looks. They're getting the ball into the middle, and then I think Cloverdale has taken some shots at maybe without working, and then they still got to be, I think, be careful on not panicking and not getting soft. I think Sean has said, keep the foot on the pedal. I mean, South Putnam still wants to play a half-court game. You cannot let them play a half-court game. Keep the pressure. Keep the trapping going, because you know, if you want to let up, you can let up with 2 or 3 minutes to go, but I think you still have to apply the pressure.
On the flip side, for South Putnam, they want to be as competitive this year as possible, try to build off last night's win, get into this championship game, and try to make the end of the season as good as they possibly can. But as reference, they had one time with four freshmen on the floor during this game. What do you see the future of this South Putnam program kind of turning into these next few years?
Nothing but bright. Those freshmen, Greg, from the sixth grade, they've only lost something like one or two games, maybe three, in the three grades, because a couple of those years, they didn't lose a game, and they won undefeated, won the county in this county, and played some other things. So that freshman class has been the class that they've been waiting for since probably when they saw them in the fifth grade.
So 37-18 our score. Scoring for South Putnam, Plunkett leads them with seven. He didn't score in the first quarter. Four for Scott, three for Fanning, two for Watson, two for Long. For Cloverdale, Neese with 13, Moore with 9, Wilkes with 8, Winders with 4, Path adds 3 points, and Moore, 3 fouls, Sean, in the first half.
Yeah, you know, going back to what Coach is talking about a little bit there, too, with the freshmen for South Putnam, you know, Coach Dean's got it. He's got an interesting job over there, because with freshmen, you want them to get out there and learn, but you've got to also be able to coach them up and give them the positive. You can't give them the negative all the time, or you could lose them. So you got to be able to build them up and let them understand this is going to be a tough season for them, more than likely. But you're building towards a future. Man, I'm telling you, this is going to be a team to watch in a few years from now.
Before we start the third quarter of play, let's tell you about some great scholarships that are available for high school seniors. The Foundation for Rural Service is in cooperation with the NTCA, the Rural Broadband Association, invites rural high school seniors to apply for one of 30 $2,500 scholarships being offered to eligible high school seniors. Applications must be postmarked to the Foundation for Rural Service no later than March 1st of 2016. Apply online, weendeavor.com/aboutus/scholarships for application requirements. Cloverdale with the ball to start quarter number three, trying to wrap up a county championship. Knocked off Greencastle in overtime last night. Trying to put away South Putnam, and a blocking foul going to be called. Bang, bang call, but would have been against Moore, would have been his fourth.
Boy, I tell you, that was a great idea there from McHugh. Take the contact and go. I don't think he sold it enough, but, man, he about got number four against Jalen. And I was just getting ready to allude to that, too. I think he's got to play foul-free this entire quarter.
Neese drives by one man, kicks it to Moore for an open three, and buries it. Moore with a dozen.
They don't call him the Lieber State Park Splash Brothers for nothing.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I forgot that they do have that nickname.
Moore with a dozen, his second three. Neese just won three in the first half. That was on the opening possession of the game for Cloverdale.
Oh, yeah, you got to hit him there. They missed Plunkett in the post. He had good position on knees for a moment.
Uh-oh, that's where he hit from last night.
Yep.
Yeah, he comes off a little screen down there, and he was, I think, 3 or 4 for 4 last night against North Putnam on that same play.
He's got 10 now. Teams exchange three-point baskets here in the early going of the third quarter.
Yeah, I think as a team going defensively against Punky, you got to realize that dead on is where he likes to shoot from.
Path of the low block doesn't go. Wilkes couldn't corral the rebound. Out of bounds to South Putnam.
I tell you, this zone defense and that pressure there, that press from Cloverdale, anytime that you're throwing the ball backwards is not a good thing.
Shot taken and missed by Dalton Scott. Little contact there. Officials let him play through. Moore was looking for Wilkes. Ball knocked out of bounds by Scott. It'll be Cloverdale basketball.
South Putnam really, they're having to work to get the ball across the half court line. And you know, that 8-9 second mark almost every time they try to bring it up.
Nice step back three. Beauty.
Wow. And you can see right there, Stewart just after it went in, just shook his head like, what do I do against that?
Well, at this level, that's an unguardable shot, to be honest with you.
And he works on that, I'll say that. Do we have a – well, I shouldn't say we. I know Cloverdale has stations, and that's one of the stations we use in shooting. But there's another freshman. He is really smooth.
Plunkett now with a dozen. He's carrying the offensive mail for South Putnam, but it's about getting enough stops to try to make up a 20-point deficit, which is not going to be easy, but there's one right there, and then that's the foul by Moore, and that's four.
Yep.
So Moore commits the turnover and then picks up his fourth foul with 5:45 to play in the third quarter.
That's a frustration foul right here for Moore. He tries to make a fancy move and loses the basketball.
Yeah, defense is just too close to him. He should have kicked it out.
Good hands, and then they get him right here. Good call.
We'd expect Moore to sit into the fourth quarter at this point with Cloverdale staked to a 20-point lead. They will now bring out Nice to play the point of that zone defense.
Coach, I travel.
Plunkett drug that pivot foot.
Got
away able to get away with it. And then Path fouls him on the closeout. And that's a 3-point attempt, so three shots coming up for Plunkett.
Coach, we were talking at the half, as you see the replay of Plunkett getting fouled there. Yeah. I find it amazing. In 51 years of coaching, you were never tossed from a game. We saw John Calipari didn't even get 2 minutes into the game last night and got tossed.
Plunkett now has made his last three free throws after missing his opening two of the game.
Yeah, he's starting to find that scoring touch now.
Long will check back in for South Putnam. This is just the fifth game he has played this year. Long, a senior. Plunkett cashes in all three.
I think Long's coming back off an injury, and he really was a big factor last year. He plays pretty well.
Nice changes speeds, gets the jump shot that misses wide to the right, and the rebound to South Putnam.
You can see how strong Long is. I remember the name from football as well.
Yes, he is.
With South Putnam and just a wide body.
Has a little space and throws the left hand up and in. Long with four, and Cloverdale will take a timeout. It'll be a 30-second break, so we'll keep it right here. Cloverdale have to readjust things a bit now with Moore on the sidelines with those four fouls.
Long, you see the replay there. Might have got away with shuffling the feet a little bit, but got the bucket to go.
Moore in those four games had just converted three field goals on the season coming in, averaging 2 points a game. You mentioned the fact that Cloverdale plays twice. South Putnam a little busier down the stretch. They've got four games remaining. They will play Eminence on Tuesday, followed up by Owen Valley at home on Friday. They'll travel to North Vermillion the following night and then close down with Riverton Park the Tuesday before the sectionals begin. Tonight, just the 18th game of the season for South Putt. Turnover committed by Cloverdale. Plunkett off the window.
Good shot.
He's got 17.
You know, you talk about that schedule for South Putnam as they close it out. Those are some winnable games in there, too. And that gives them some confidence going into the end of the season.
Nice, deep three. Much like momentum in baseball is the next day's starting pitcher. Momentum for Cloverdale, the next jump shot from Cooper Nice.
Stewart gives the exact same reaction that time, just immediately chin hits the chest and just kind of shakes his head. How do you do to that?
Long in the low block, no, and here comes Neese into the front court for Cloverdale.
Coming into the game last night about Cooper. He had 7 double-doubles on the season coming into last night's game. He had 4 straight.
Wilkes misses the putback and then gets fouled by Scott. Good hustle by Wilkes.
I like that young man's game. Only 2 years of playing basketball, but you see, the got a great motor.
Yeah. He has an act where the ball is at. He just pulled up short on that shot.
Robert Nally going to check in for Cloverdale, give Paff a breather. Nally, a 6-foot senior, averages a point and a half a game. Neese quickly racing over to track down the ball. Now the 3, no good. And the fight for the loose ball, touched last by South Putnam, out of bounds to Cloverdale.
You got to credit Wilkes there again for just battling down on the offensive glass, trying to get a rebound.
Grunlock now will check back in for South Putnam. Long will have a seat. Some high schools will practice the occasional junk defense, the box and one, the triangle and two. Others, that's not part of their vernacular, but with Moore on the bench, now might be the time to play that if you're South Putnam.
Oh, good look.
Neese looking for Nally, wasn't ready for it. 6th Cloverdale turnover. South Putt has gotten this as close as 13 since that opening run by Cloverdale. But it's virtually been double digits since the opening minutes of the game. South Putnam continues to be awfully deliberate with their offense. Looking for a good shot, and they get it. Scott, the basket.
Nice shot by Dalton Scott. I was watching Neese and Plunkett, and there for a minute, you know, they kind of got the similar hairdos. They almost look like the same player on the floor.
Last touch by South Putnam. It'll be Cloverdale ball. Love the hustle from Plunkett. And Brennan Hall going to check in now for Cloverdale. Going to give Wilkes a breather. And they're going to call him for palming the basketball.
Yeah. Good call. I mean, it's something that doesn't get called enough anymore, in my opinion. I'm a fan of defense, I guess. You know, I mean, I like to see the ball go through the hoop, don't get me wrong, but.
But if you want to call it, you can almost call it on every player.
Yeah.
They all seem to do that today.
And Moore sits with 4 fouls for Cloverdale. He's been on the bench now for the last 3 minutes.
Say, missed opportunity there a minute ago by Grunlock. There was nobody around him from the top.
South Putt fires a 3. That does not go. Shot taken and missed by Stewart. Neese, runner. And that really is Cloverdale's best option at this point.
Yep.
Just try to get Neese going to the basket, and you can get the shot, go to the free throw line.
I really like what they do there, too. They overload the opposite side of the floor, so you just have somebody coming to set a screen for Cooper.
Neese at 29 points a game, now has 20. And as a perfect 3 of 3 from the line, he is the only Cloverdale player to go to the free throw line tonight.
Which is amazing when you think about it, because Jalen Moore went, 16 times last night? He was 15 of 16 from the line?
Yeah, he drove last night and got the fouls. Tonight he just didn't pull up, or he got a couple of charging.
2-3 zone this time down by Cloverdale.
Well, they say sometimes you're the hammer, sometimes you're the nail.
Yeah.
Oh. Good hands.
Uh-oh, they're going to let him open.
3 in the corner, left short. And the rebound to Cloverdale. Nice will lead the break. Nice with 23.
Man, he's quick with the basketball.
And a timeout going to be taken by South Putnam.
Great body control there from Cooper on the run out. Coach Dean very upset out in the middle of the floor.
He's got to be awfully careful. And here it comes. Timeout going to be called. I thought he might have gotten something a bit stronger than that.
Yeah.
And it kind of unsure. It's going to be a 30-second timeout or a full time. It'll be a 30. Three was taken and missed by Plunk, and I believe Greg Dean thought he was fouled on the shot. And that was the reason for kind of the nose-to-nose conversation that took place ever so briefly.
I tell you, the patience of referees, officials, it's amazing at times. It really is. You know, you can only compare it to, like, daycare workers and grandmas. They're the only other people I've ever seen to have as much patience.
Yeah. So South Putnam will bring it the length of the floor. And this game is kind of oscillated between, say, 15 and 20 points for nearly its entirety. Cloverdale doing a good job of closing out on the wings. Trying to give up open threes. Everything outside the arc this possession for South Putt. Scott steps just inside it and drains about a 17-footer. One minute to go in the quarter.
That's 8 points now for Scott.
Nice, 26. And the offense has been pretty much entirely him since Moore exited with those four fouls.
He's got 13 points here in the third quarter alone.
I know, it was a good step back again. He got the defense off of him.
Plunkett, and a reach-in foul going to be called against Cloverdale. This one goes against the senior in Hall.
Let's see, because, boy, it's going to be close.
The two seniors on this Cloverdale roster are both guys that come off the bench in Nally and Hall. So not that Cloverdale is thinking about next year in any way, shape, form, or fashion. They're focused on this season. But they will return their starting five intact a year from now. Three for South Putt does not go. Nice the weak side rebound. 26 seconds and counting left to go in the quarter. And Patrick Rady says hold for one. This is the part in the radio broadcast where I let Bob Lovell plug his new book. You've got some time to kill. Nice. Floater.
Oh, good block.
Blocked by Plunkett. Ball out of bounds with 0.3 seconds left to go in the quarter. Cloverdale will have the ball. It will have to be a tip at the rim with 0.3 remaining. And that is the right call. It was last touched by South Putnam. Tipped away, and that is the end of the quarter. 53 for Cloverdale, South Putnam 34. 8 minutes away from Cloverdale, trying to claim that elusive county championship. Back with more in a moment on Endeavor Communications.
Endeavor eShield gives you peace of mind that your home, family, and business are safe. eShield provides burglar protection, leak detection, carbon monoxide, smoke and heat detection, and asset protection to secure your valuables. And of course, there's 24/7 monitoring. Total Connect Remote Services controls your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish most.
Tonight's game brought to us by Endeavor Communications and their ETV television, including Big Ten, SEC networks, NFL networks, lifestyle and family shows. And as a free added bonus, TV subscribers receive Watch TV Everywhere, which lets you watch select TV programs on your PC, tablet, or smartphone with an internet or wireless connection. WeEndeavor.com or 800-922-6677 for more information.
I watch TV Everywhere. It's pretty awesome. That's how guys like us that are gone a lot stay up to date with things. We tune in and watch games. You shouldn't do it while you're driving.
No. Moore sits on the bench with four fouls. Nally back in there for Cloverdale. Plunkett off the window and scores. 19 for Plunkett. All those coming from the second quarter on.
Yeah, he's having a great game. That's two more points than he had all last night.
Nice from the midcourt logo. Might have been a bit of a heat check for Cooper. Yeah. At the other end, baseline corner, jump shot is good by Dalton Scott. He's got 10.
I know he's got the green shoes, he's got the green on the jersey, but evidently he's got the green light as well.
At the other end, good look for Hall, the senior.
Good pass.
He's got 2. We've talked about the future a lot for South Putnam.
Wait,
but illustrate it for you all, but 4 of their points have come from their freshman class tonight. And Plunkett and Scott have combined for 29, but when you have freshmen, you also have freshman mistakes, like that one right there. Turnover committed.
You know, I think something else important to point out, Jimmy Rutter for them last night had 8 points, and I don't even think I've seen him play tonight so far.
Watson will check in for South Putnam. Nice draws a double team. Shoots over it and scores in another 3. Nice with 29. Right at his average on the season. 58-38. Been kind of series of jabs from Cloverdale since the first quarter. They landed the haymakers the first 5 minutes, and they've played keep away ever since. And South Putnam turns it over for a second consecutive trip.
Yeah, Cloverdale couldn't have had a better start, because playing a team that wants to play half court, you have to get out and get that jump on them, and not allow them. You know, they South Putnam has been very patient with the ball, and so that's helped Cloverdale.
Nice splits 3 defenders. Trying to pass to a teammate, had it knocked away.
Wow.
Then goes his own version of a 3-man weave around defenders. The 3 taken and missed by Watts, and finally South Putnam tracks it down. 3 top of the key for South Putnam is good. That's Stewart with the triple. 5:40 left to play.
Yeah, Stewart knocking it down that time. Need more of that. For South Putnam, try to keep pace with Cooper.
That was from the meter line on the volleyball court. Nice with 32.
You think he knows that Trey Lyles is sitting just about 10 feet away over there? See those two have a little bit of a shooting contest.
I hope that Cooper's performance today makes Butler fans smile after a rough home loss to Xavier. They've got to wait a year. Cooper just a junior. Moore back in there. He basically sat for an entire quarter with 4 fouls. And for the first time in several possessions, Nice can somewhat play off the ball. Or not.
Oh, my goodness.
35 for Cooper Nice.
Well, I hope he's got a deep bank account, because he's been calling long distance a lot tonight. Those charges are going to be racking up.
And it's so smooth. You can tell me it's in his range. He's not for it's a good rhythm shot. Defense has backed off of him, and
3 in the corner. Does not get the friendly roll. Nice the rebound. Nice going to pull again. That's 38, kids.
Good grief. His season high is 40 versus Clay City, and he may top that tonight.
Timeout taken by South Putnam. It'll be a full timeout. Allow us to step away. A standing ovation for Cooper Nice. He's 3 points shy of tying South Putnam by his lonesome. Clovers lead by 26 on Endeavor Communications.
TV Everywhere is a value-added entertainment option which gives Endeavor Television subscribers the ability to watch TV programs on their PC, laptop, tablet, or smartphone. When you subscribe to an Endeavor TV package, you receive select TV programming that is available in that package free of charge. You can view Watch TV Everywhere programs just about anywhere. All you need is an internet or Wi-Fi connection. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details about Watch.
Greg Rakestraw, Sean Walker, Pat Rady with you. Have we talked publicly about the project yet that you're working on guy to my right?
It'd be a great time to talk about it. Actually, we're working on a documentary on Pat Rady, the life and basketball and his life and life on and off the court, and we're still acquiring footage, which is amazing. Every time we think we're done, we stick another camera in your face, coach, and follow you around. It seems like they keep honoring you for different things.
You might want to add some footage of Cooper Neese, given the way he is playing tonight. Now, 8 threes for Cooper, 38 points for the game, and 25 in the second half. 67-41, Cloverdale now their largest lead against South Putnam.
I'm not always a betting man, but if Cooper Neese touches the ball on the offense anywhere within the half-court set, he's letting it fly the next time.
Cloverdale on their way to a county championship, their 15th win of the year.
Good pass. Good defense by Hall, though.
Shot taken and missed by Grunlock. Moore, he'll try his hand at it. No, but he's fouled. Foul by Scott, and Jalen Moore will shoot three.
Good sign of sportsmanship there. As he went down, Stewart went over and helped him up from the other team. You like to see that. Good call right here as he just crashes into him with the body.
Moore on the season was a 61% free throw shooter. That was going into last night's game where he made 15 of 16. That number has increased dramatically, but he misses the first one here. And make it 0 for 2. Watson now will check back in. Scott will have a seat. Cloverdale at 15 wins, and you would expect they're probably going to get to 17 before they get to the sectional. What is unique is the fact they have that entire last week of the season off. A lot of times you kind of schedule that just as kind of a catch-all in case you got to have some makeup games. But with the lack of snow we have had so far this winter, knock on wood.
Yeah, we're not complaining.
That's not the case. Now, there's snow in the forecast the next couple of days. But if you can get to this part of February without having any snow makeup games, life is pretty good. Jump ball is called, and the arrow will point to Cloverdale. 9 turnovers now for South Putt.
The sophomore Winder sticking his nose in there and grabbing hold of that basketball. Yeah. Grunlock's got to keep a hold of that. Got to keep it away from him.
Right now, some more of the seniors getting some playing time for South Putnam. The fan will come back in for Stewart. McHugh, Long, and Grunlock all on the floor. South Putnam will get another freshman, and Austin Arnold, into the game. So all five of their freshmen on the varsity roster have now played tonight. Cooper Neese by his lonesome might make lime green shoes popular in West Central Indiana, given the way he has played this evening.
Well, it's perfect, you know. The St. Patrick's Day is approaching.
Turnover committed by Cloverdale. All right, what is, I'm sure you've had this conversation off the air. Let's have it on the air. What's Patrick going to be focused on with his team, knowing, yes, you've got two more games to go, but you've really got 2 weeks to get fine-tuned for the postseason. What is this team going to continue working on before the calendar turns to March?
Well, I think defense has got to be improved. I think that's always, no matter who you are, when you are, when you play, defense has got to be stressed, and rebounding, and then get good, keep good pressure. I mean, that's I think it's very important to keep pressure on the ball, and that's where they play. They play an 84-foot game, and they'll keep working on that.
Of course, these teams will know their sectional draw 8 days from now, announced Sunday the 21st. If I can plug the day job, you can hear that on 93.5 FM and 1070 The Fan. You can watch it on ihsaatv.org, which will be produced in part by the good folks at MTC Sports. Bob Lovell and Charlie Hall. Moore, top of the key three, does not go. Hall the rebound and kicks it out to Neese with 2:10 left to play. South Putt got this down to a 13-point game midway through the third quarter. But Neese is just going to hold the ball out here a little bit. Just trying to...
This is the only time as a fan that I don't like not having a shot clock because I want to force him to shoot it one more time to see if it goes in. That's what I want to see.
think he's content to pound the pavement here as long as South Putnam lets him. And they're going to call him for a five-second violation, which is a bit touchy this late in the game, especially when he's making an effort to break away from the defender. But that whistle also serves as a way to get three reserves into the game and give a bit of a curtain call to guys like Nick Winders, Cooper Neese, and Jalen Moore. Neese will finish with 38 points, Moore with 15, Winders with 4.
What a great game for those guys tonight.
Shot taken and missed. This is Parker Watts, another freshman on the floor for Cloverdale. Paff does have a three this evening. Well, in our first game tonight, it was a remarkable reversal of fortunes from the first meeting to the second. Greencastle had beaten North Putt by 47. Nally's shot is blocked. It'll be out of bounds to South Putnam. North Putt turns on and beat Greencastle the next time they play by 4. On the other hand, this game will almost finish with the exact same score. They played back on December the 15th. Cloverdale won 73-46. It's 70-41 with 49 seconds left to play. Hall will shoot 2 free throws.
Yeah, I thought they really did a good job of coming here tonight and taking care of business. And, you know, we made the comment that we thought maybe South Putnam was watching and said, hey, we can do this too. You know, look what North Putnam just went out and did. But you got to wonder if Cloverdale was watching saying, hey, that's not going to happen to us. And they really established themselves.
I was very proud of the start that Coach Rady had them in. The one uptown, too, I said I'd be neutral, but it's sure happy to see my son get his first championship coaching. And that's a thrill.
71-41, 45 seconds to play. Three does not go for Stewart. Wilkes with the rebound. Again, this is a Cloverdale team that can do some damage in the postseason. There's no doubt about that. Whatever they do not accomplish this year, they got an even better look a year from now. Wilkes continues the hustle with the rebound. Ball knocked out of bounds by Paff. And for South Putnam, the future's bright. As Sean said, there's a couple three wins maybe on that schedule left in the regular season. You never know what the draw might look like for your sectional. Because after Cloverdale, it's really a very evenly balanced group in that Southmont sectional. Shot blocked, but a foul going to be called, and McHugh will shoot a couple of free throws.
And immediately Brendan Hall looks over at Coach and says, that's my fault. You know, realizing there's 10 seconds left, I should just let him go. But, you know, sometimes it's tough to concede that bucket and just say, hey, go ahead.
Want to thank the good folks at Greencastle High School for having us here the last couple of days. They have a tremendous athletic staff here. And this, I'm glad I was able to cross this off the list. I have not done a basketball game from this building before tonight. What a great venue and environment this is. Closing seconds. Another three for South Putnam. That does not go. And ball game is over. Wilkes shot wouldn't have counted had it gone. Final score this evening. Cloverdale 71, South Putnam 42. The Clovers, Putnam County champs. We'll take this quick timeout, come back and wrap it up next as you're watching on Endeavor Communications. It is the E-Shield Security postgame show. Greg Rakestraw, Sean Walker, and Pat Rady with you on MTC Sports. E-Shield Security provides security protection for your home or business. Powered by quality Honeywell products, Endeavor E-Shield helps protect what you cherish most, including burglary and intrusion detection, fire, smoke, and carbon monoxide protection, and so much more. 800-922-6677. Call that number today for a free on-site security quote. Cloverdale got up by double digits in the opening 3 minutes. South Putt never got back within a dozen. The lead went from 15 to 30 in the final quarter, largely because of the efforts of one Cooper Neese. He would finish with 38 points, 8 threes, in addition to the hardware that he and his teammates are receiving right now for winning the Putnam County Classic. Cooper is going to be our player of the game. Sean, what a show he put on at half number two when his running mate and Jalen Moore was on the bench.
Well, I tell you, he went unconscious at one point in time. He hit 8 threes. He had 4 of them there in the fourth quarter, and not one of them was within 3 feet from the line. I mean, he was so deep, it was ridiculous. Great shooting touch from him tonight, and they needed it with Moore in foul trouble and just really blew this one out of proportion.
What does this county championship mean to the folks in Cloverdale?
Oh, big. Big. We need to in the county. Putnam County is still one of the areas where the basketball is still important, and the county attorney is a big factor of a lot of people's lives, and you look forward to winning it. And a lot of times it's bigger than your conference, but not the sectional. Now, the sectional is still the key, but the county attorney is right there.
Well, Patrick Grady hopes this is a precursor, not just for the sectional, but for cutting down the nets after the sectional. You know it's big when they offer you a ladder and you have won a championship here in the county.
Now, I got to ask, you always brought Margaret out and had her help you cut down the nets. Is he going to go get Mom and bring her down?
Well, I don't know. This is his first one. Yeah, it's his first one. Yeah. They'll probably have Johnny come down.
They'll pose for some more pictures. And with that, we will bid a fond farewell to you from the McAnally Center tonight. Again, this is a service of Endeavor Communications. We certainly hope you've enjoyed watching tonight's games. We have most certainly enjoyed bringing them to you. Pat, you are always welcome in the broadcast booth with us at any time.
Well, thank you, Greg. It was an honor to be with you, and I'm just so impressed with the way you broadcast things, and also when you replaced Dockage on the show, the time I told you that before, and you're very professional, and it was my honor and my privilege.
Well, thanks for joining us. Looking forward to getting to work on that documentary in the very near future. Sean, great to see you, my friend, and you and I will do this again at another classic basketball venue next Saturday.
Absolutely.
We go to Memorial Gymnasium in Kokomo for the North Central Conference tournament.
I can't wait, man. That's going to be so much fun to see that tournament.
It's okay. You've just been invited. Come on up and join us next Saturday at Memorial Gym in Kokomo. For our entire MTC Sports crew, for Pat Rady, for Sean Walker, this is Greg Rakestraw. Good night from Greencastle. Cloverdale, your Putnam County Classic champs, as you've been watching on Endeavor.